active instrument in the laparoscopy. Telescopes are of different diameter, it are of different sizes, it are of different companies, and it varies from 1.5 mm to 15 mm. These all telescopes are of different sizes, different length, and different companies. But there are three important characteristics about the telescope which you should must remember. First important characteristic about the telescope is diameter. Diameter of the telescope varies from 1.5 mm up to 15 mm. But most common diameter which is used in the laparoscopy is 10 mm. Another common diameter is 4 mm. And the third one is 5 mm. These are the three important diameter of the telescope. This is 4 mm, this is 10 mm, this is 5
mm.
4 mm is basically a cystoscope. 4 mm is basically a cystoscope and hysteroscope. Yes, 5 mm cannot be used for cysto and hysteroscope. Why? Because 4 mm, if you will put a diagnostic sheath, then it will become 5 mm. So, these are the three important which is done in most of the minimal access surgery. There are some others like the VersaScope that Ethicon is making, that is 1.8 mm for doing hysteroscopy in early perious women. But generally they are for diagnostic purposes. Because if you have to perform any myomectomy or any resection, then you need a little more diameter, because anyhow you have to take the tissue out also. So you need to dilate it little bit. So these are the three important diameter of the telescope. Now what is the difference in the diameter? Thoda camera attach kar dena. Diameter difference is that bigger the diameter of the monitor telescope, you will see more field of vision over the monitor. Bigger image and more amount of light over the monitor will be visible. If the smaller the diameter of the telescope, you have the smaller field of vision and amount of light going inside will be less. So that's why in most of the conventional surgery we use 10 mm, because it will give you more amount of light inside, because it has more fiber optics. And the second, that it will give you the big picture, full screen picture without going nearer. It is very surprising to understand that the magnification, generally we say that in laparoscopy we have 10 time magnification, we have 20 time magnification, we have 40 time magnification. This is wrong. Magnification is not only a property of telescope. Magnification depends upon the distance from the target. If you are very nearer, if you are just about to touch, at that time magnification may be 120 times. And if you are far away, then there will be no magnification and the image can be rectified. It may be smaller. So if you want to have slightly big field of vision, then you should use the 10 mm telescope. Another property of the telescope is optical axis. What is optical axis? Optical axis . If you see, these are the two telescopes, and this is the field of vision. In this telescope, this is 0 degree, and this is the field of vision. It is a perpendicular cut here, just like this one. If you see, this has a perpendicular cut, and this telescope has an oblique cut. So in this the field of vision is 30 degree deviated to one side. By definition, what is field of vision? Field of vision is the angle between longitudinal axis and the center of the field of vision. What is field of vision? Suppose you will go very nearer to any object, field of vision will be small. But if you will go far away from any object, field of vision will be big. This is not only for a telescope, it is for your simple digital camera also. If you will go very nearer to any person, you can see his eye only. But if you will go far away, then you can take a picture of a mountain also. Because field of vision will increase. Exactly same way, this is the field of vision. If you are away, field of vision is big. If you are nearer, field of vision is small. But the center of the field of vision will be always same. So the optical axis is the angle between longitudinal axis and the center of the field of vision. In zero-degree telescope, the angle between longitudinal axis and the center of the field of vision will be same, zero. But in 30 degree, angle between the longitudinal axis and the center of the field of vision, this will be 30 degree. Here this is 30 degree. So 30 degree telescope is better than 0 degree. Reason behind that, if you will rotate the telescope, you can see 30 degree more wider field of vision. How it happens, I am just going to demonstrate you here. 30 degree telescope has more depth of perception, and 30 degree telescope can show you the recesses of the body. Recesses of the body, like if you want to see the paracolic gutter, if you want to see the all the other area in the deep cavity, 30 degree has a privilege. But 30 degree has one demerit, that 30 degree telescopes are not very good if you want to have in the inexperienced hand. Reason behind, if the cables are not positioned correctly, then surgeon can do some mistake. So this is the difference between the optical axis. That is, one is 0 degree, another is 30 degree. Now optical axis is not limited only to 0 or 30. Optical axis starts from 7 degree and it ends it up to 120 degree. What is that? Suppose you want to perform thoracoscopy, then you can get 45 degree telescope or sometime 90 degree telescope. 90 degree telescope will show you completely down. And the urologist sometimes they use 120 degree. What is that? Reverse viewing telescope. Telescope will go into the ureter and they will cross the pelvis and they can see the pelvis down there. That is known as reverse viewing telescope, that is 120 degree. So optical axis varies a lot. But the problem is that if you will keep one 120 degree telescope, then what will be the advantage? Advantage is that if you will put inside, you can see your own cannula, isn't it? The cannula of the optical port you can see, because it will be reverse viewing. But if you have to see in front, you have to change your telescope, take another. Exactly same way, if you will keep 45 degree, what will be the advantage? You can see on the side nicely. But if you have to see in front, in those situation, you need the another. But 30 degree telescope, if you will take, it will solve the purpose of 0 degree and 30 degree both. So that's why 30 degree is more popular. 45 degree is not that much popular. Because if you will take 30 degree, you don't need 0 degree. And because it is showing in front also, you can see it is showing in front also, and it is showing on the side also. So both the purposes of 0 degree and 30 degree, both can be solved with the 30 degree only. And if you are using 45 degree, then you have to keep 145 and 10. So generally that's why 30 degree is more popular telescope. Worldwide people ask for 30 degree only, because if 30 degree is there, that is sufficient. Now what is the difference? I will demonstrate to you. Suppose this is a telescope and you will attach it like this. Any telescope we can get it. Suppose this is the telescope and just you attach it here like you attach, this is the telescope attached, and then you will attach the light cable. This is the telescope attached, and here is the light cable attached. Right, now we can see here that in this telescope right now we are seeing in his face. But if I will rotate it this way, I can see this side. And if I will rotate the other side, I can see this side. If I will rotate it down, I can see above. The fans also I can see. And if I will keep it up, I can see the table. I can see this box. I can see other telescopes. This is the difference. Just by rotation, you can change the direction of the field of vision. And it is reverse to the light cable. If light cable is right, you are seeing left. If light cable is left, you are seeing right.
In relation to the camera?
Yes. No, camera you should never rotate.
Yeah, but sometimes you're not rotating, so it will give you a different view.
I am coming to that point. And if you will put it down, it is up. Remember that there are two type of movement. One movement is movement of the telescope. That is necessary sometime. And another movement is, suppose I am seeing like that, and if I want to see here, then I will move in this direction. I want to see this side, then I will move this direction. And another movement is movement of the camera, like this. I have moved and everything upside down. You got it? Suppose I am seeing here, like this. This is correct. But if I will show this way, she is looking upside down. Her head is upside down. Can you see? So remember, this is a blender. You should never ever rotate this CCD. This is known as CCD, charge coupled device or camera. It should never be rotated. If you will rotate this, the complete image will rotate, and there will be complete disorientation. So this cable should must project down, and these points should must be towards 12 o'clock. It should be at 12 o'clock. How to hold the telescope? This is also very important. Generally, what people do, sometimes they hold like that. Sometimes they hold it here. Sometimes they hold here. This is not ideal. There is only one way of holding the telescope. Telescope should be held this way. This is the way of holding telescope. This is the way. And only way. How to hold it? You take index finger and thumb. Make it apart. And this will go in this groove. This groove is made for that only. So that your index finger and thumb can go. And this cable and CCD cable, both should be fixed between these two fold of your finger. And this way you have to hold the telescope. This is the way of holding telescope. You should never keep your finger over here. If you keep it, it will drop. It will open because it is the iris like, this is lock. And if you touch it, you will drop your telescope. If you will keep it here, you will change the focus. We will touch it and focus will be changed. This is for knob, for focusing. You should never hold here. This is just knobs for different settings. I will discuss all these settings just now. And if you will press it here or here, this setting will be altered. So how to hold? This is the way of holding, this way. And you can see I am not touching these two also. I will touch only if I need it by the thumb. And this is the way of holding the telescope. And this is the convenient way of resting position of your arm also. So if you will hold like that, you will never change it unknowingly, because for changing it you have to put some effort. So always it will be there. Now if you will not keep it guarded, like if you are not taking care of the cable, then also this is wrong, because by gravity slowly it will come down, and there will be a big mistake for the surgeon. That's why the surgeons, they don't like 30 degree. Why they don't like? I will just demonstrate you. Suppose this is a CBD, and here is a cystic duct. Let us take, imagine that, suppose let us see on the monitor, and let me focus it a little bit. Yes, this is focusing, and suppose this is cystic duct and this is CBD going down. Now what happened? This camera person is not taking care of the cable, and this cable is turned down, like niche down kar do. Cable is turning down. This complete cable is down. Now what happened? That everything is looking up, isn't it? Now to visualize the gallbladder or visualize the cystic duct, the surgeon will start giving more traction like this. And if the traction is given, what happened? There is chanting. And in this chanting, this CBD, this portion is looking like cystic duct, and this is looking like cystic artery. But actually it was CBD which got tented. Why it got tented? Because of the wrong position of the this light cable, and because now this telescope is showing up. And if it is showing up, then you have the traction in wrong direction, and then there will be mistake. Exactly again same way coming to the hysterectomy. Now suppose this is the fundus of the uterus. This is fundus of the uterus. Here this is, suppose this is fundus, and here is the uterine artery. Suppose this is uterine artery, this is uterine artery, and this is the uterus. Now what happens? That your good camera person has made it like this. Now what will happen? You are thinking that I cannot see whatever the structure is towards the left, isn't it? Now your uterine manipulation, the person who was doing uterine manipulation, he will start giving the traction towards the other side like this, isn't it? And then you will damage the ureter of this side, will be damaged. Because due to over traction, ureter will be pulled to the midline, and you will do the mistake. That's why it is said that 30 degree is not a very good telescope in the hand of beginners. Because just by rotation, you have this problem that right now you were seeing the Mr. X, and if you will rotate it, you will start seeing Mr. Y. And then you will do the mistake. But it has advantage also. Like suppose this is a mobile here, and it is kept like that. With the 0 degree, you can see only the fixed target, like you can see the back portion of this mobile. If I want to see the screen of the mobile, there is no way, because I cannot pierce the patient body, isn't it? There is no way. But with the 30 degree, even if you will go nearer, suppose with the 0 degree I am going nearer. If I will go nearer, I will see more magnified image, but I cannot see the detail from behind. But in 30 degree, just you rotate it and you go. Can you see now? All the digits are visible. And this is the privilege of the 30 degree. And now you can see all the digits, whatever is there, it is visible, 7, 8, 6, 5, everything I can see. This is the privilege of the 30 degree that you don't have with the 0 degree. So suppose you want to dissect the gallbladder from the gallbladder bed, and you want to see the fossa. Suppose this is gallbladder and this is liver. You want to see in this groove. You cannot see with the 0 degree, but with the 30 degree you can see. Suppose you want to see the back of the posterior wall of the uterus during LAVH. You can see with the 30 degree. 0 degree will not show you. Suppose you want to see the hiatuses, you want to see the paracolic gutter, you want to see in between the coil of intestine, you want to see the infundibulum, you want to see even in the cystoscopy or hysteroscopy. That's why 0 degree cystoscope and hysteroscopes are not available also. Because if you want to see the ostia, right ostia, then cable should be left. If you want to see left ostia, cable should be right. If you have a 0 degree hysteroscope, then only you will see the fundus. Only what you can do, you can tilt it like that. if you have a hysteroscope and this is uterus, if you will tilt it this way, complete uterus will get mobilized, isn't it? Because it is fixed by the cervix. If you try to see the right ostia and you think that I can see like that, you cannot. Because if you do this way, complete uterus will be mobilized. So in hysteroscopy, cystoscopy, it is more important to have the 30-degree telescope. In laparoscopy, you can manage because you have the ability to move it. So sometime down, sometime up, you can manage. You will not get the maximum vision, but at least some angle you can manage. But in hysteroscopy, cystoscopy, even you cannot see the ostia also. So that's why more angled telescopes are better. In our opinion, that every surgeon should start working with the 30-degree telescope. 30-degree. Why? Because if you will not work with the 30-degree in the initial stage of learning, then later adapting it will be difficult. You will be surprised that most of the senior surgeons, they are working with the 0-degree. And now, pardon? Most of the senior surgeons, senior surgeons, older surgeons, the senior surgeons, our one generation above surgeons, generally they work still with the 0-degree. And they are happy with the 0-degree. And they recommend also 0-degree. Why? They are used to 0-degree. And this is one problem. Another problem, that they don't rely upon their camera person. Because they don't have only one team. They keep on varying their registrar, their registrant is changing. So they don't rely upon them. They want the fixed camera and they don't want to have any this type of change. So 0-degree is having only one advantage, that even in inexperienced hand, it is safer. Because in 0-degree, there is no possibility of changing the image. Even in the 0-degree, if you will rotate the CCD, image will rotate. Rotating the CCD, rotating the camera, is just like someone will rotate my complete body, my leg is up and head is down. And rotating the telescope is just rotating the neck. If I want to see this side, I will see here, I want to see there. So, you can just consider one example that 0-degree telescope has cervical spondylitis. In 0-degree telescope, they don't have neck movement. 0-degree telescope, if you have to see this side, complete body has to be moved. Isn't it? And if this side, then complete body has to be moved. 0-degree doesn't have this any ability to move the neck. Because there is no angle on the neck. It is fixed. Fixed axis only you have. Just like another example, suppose you have a torch. And this torch is in your hand. And you rotate your torch in the same axis, nothing will happen, light will go there only. But you keep your torch at some angle in your hand, and then you rotate that way, then you can get an arc. And through that arc, you can see the wider angle. Exactly, this is the difference between the 0-degree and 30-degree telescope. And this way, 30-degree telescope is preferred. So this was the second property of the telescope, that is the optical axis. Optical axis. First property was the diameter. Diameter I will show you again, just for simple example, that here we can see that this is a full image, isn't it? Full screen. But I will change the diameter now and I will demonstrate you some smaller diameter telescope like this telescope. This is a smaller diameter and we will see here just after attaching, it is showing you a smaller image. Can you see? It's the only the smaller central point and other point is dead. Only the smaller point will be visible and other point is dead. So this is the difference between the, and amount of light also was less. Amount of light is a limiting factor. That's why more diameter telescope. Although now the technology is getting advanced and the good quality a smaller diameter telescope is coming into the market slowly. And maybe after a few years you might have the good technology with the good fibers, you have the better 5mm telescopes available. Now the third property of the telescope is number of rod lenses. If you see inside the telescope, we have drawn this image. Inside there are number of rod lenses. What is rod lenses? That Hopkins has revolutionized the concept of the new generation of telescope. This is known as Hopkins telescope. And if you see, these are the rod lenses. Rod lenses are basically a prism. And there are two convexoplano lens. One is, this is known as eyepiece, and this is known as object piece. Object piece is for taking the image of object. Eyepiece is back. This is eyepiece. Here, this is eyepiece. Eyepiece is just to see, either by the eye or you can attach the camera. An image is taken by this eyepiece and it is given to these prisms. And this is known as rod lenses. These are the rod lenses. These are the rod lenses. More the number of rod lenses, better will be the quality of the telescope. If you have less number of rod lenses, your telescope is not good. If you see that if the more number of rod lenses are there, there is less air gap and the quality of image will be better. If you see the same company, they make two type of telescope and the quality is different. Like this is a Stahl telescope. If you see, it is written Hopkins. The name Hopkins, this trade name, is given to the urologist who has first developed this Hopkins telescope system. If you buy any telescope of Stahl, you will see there, it is written here, Hopkins. Hopkins 1, Hopkins 2, Hopkins 3. Hopkins was a urologist. And he has developed the first time this rigid rod lens system with the less air gap. And this you can use, you can perform, and you can use for the procedures. Now, Hopkins lens system has this advantage that you have the less air gap and more number of rod lenses. But it varies company to company. Just like, I will demonstrate you that this is one company and this is another company. Like anyone, let us take this one. And these are the two telescopes in my hand. This is one of the, I will not take the name. This is one of the Chinese company and this is one of the German company. If you see, the number of rod lenses in this telescope is only 6. And number of rod lenses in this telescope is 10. So, if you will see, you will get the difference.
Can the number by weight,
it is not written. This is the problem, it is not written. Yes, weight you can make out little bit, and by vision you can make out a lot. Like if you see here, just you